What's going on, everybody, and welcome to a new video. In this video, I want to talk about Musafa Jones's run defense that really did a fantastic job of slowing down Problem and resulted in him winning 28-13 in their Week 3 Ultimate League matchup. And the reason I want to touch on this topic is because since Problem has been having so much competitive success recently, his kind of single back power type of offense has really risen with that single back wing, you know, single back ace slot, single back deuce close, HB stretch combinations. A lot of people have started using it more and more online, and a lot of people have trouble stopping it, and Musafa really put on a clinic on how to do so. And the way he did it was out of the 3-4 odd formation, cover 6. And the reason you want to call cover 6 is because you really get the best of both worlds in this scenario in terms of run defense. You have Tampa 2 on one side, which allows you to have that cloud flat from the cornerback, who does a great job of setting the edge and attacking underneath as soon as the ball is basically snapped. And then you have the other side, which has the deep quarter zone from the safety, which gives you good run support in terms of that safety. He's basically going to play the run first. His run fits. He doesn't backpedal at the snap of the ball. He's going to stand still, read the backfield, and react on what he sees. So you have basically, like I said, the best of both worlds, a mix between cover 2, cover 4. You get cover 6. Now, the way Safa likes to run it is he runs the Tampa 2 side on the backside. So in this case, this guy right here is in the cloud flat. This guy right here is going to be dropping back into the deep half zone. Now, this leaves you with the Tampa, or with the cover 4 side rather, on the right side of the field. And the way he sets this up is he leaves this safety who's in that quarter zone in the quarter zone because he runs him to respect the run first. But the way he does his other adjustment is he puts his outside cornerback into a man-to-man assignment on that outside receiver. And what this is going to do is he's basically going to play the run as if he were a cloud flat zone. He's going to instantly crash towards the inside if it is a run play and play very aggressively and try to either get inside of Paul Krause and make a play or instantly engage Paul Krause and possibly have a shot at a block shed. Another thing to note, he moved Ronnie Lott out there. So big safety, higher block shed than normal defensive back. That's the kind of guy you want setting the edge. The other reason he puts him in a man-to-man assignment rather than, you know, putting him in a cloud flat like the guy on the left is that if he puts him in a cloud flat, he has the potential to get beat over the top if Problem goes with the passing play and fades Paul Krause. In this case, with the man-to-man assignment, you get the best of both worlds. You get the run support as well as the pass defense if Problem happens to go through the air, because now he's just manned up on Paul Krause. So what you're going to see right here is exactly what you want out of this style of defense. Problem going to go stretch right, and he comes screaming right through. Paul Krause doesn't get a hand on Ronnie Lott, and Ronnie Lott hits Fournette, gets carried forward a little bit, but still basically a gain of 0, and that's exactly what you want to see out of this cover 6 setup. Now right here, second play, Problem going to go with the single back A slot HB stretch, trying to mix it up a little bit. He flips the stretch to the left, so he's running it to the strong side with the tight end and the double receivers, and you're going to notice Safa goes same thing, cover 6 once again, but now he flips it. So now he wants the cover 4 side on the strong side of the field. So you have deep half right there, cloud flat on the right side, so Tampa 2, and then you're going to have on the left side, you're going to have the deep quarter zone from that safety, and once again, man-to-man assignment by the outside cornerback on the furthest outside receiver, in this case, that's Jarvis Landry, and you're going to see exactly what happens. Once again, snap of the ball, he instantly engages Jarvis Landry, so this time he doesn't come in, but that's all you want, because as you can see right here, he instantly engages and then gets an instant block shed, and that's why you want the instant engage. If he left him in the deep quarter zone, as is standard in that cover 6, at the snap of the ball, he would have backpedaled, and all that would have done would have been delayed the amount of time that it took for him to engage with Jarvis Landry, which just gives Leonard Fournette more time to either get to the edge or for Problem to read and react and cut, basically based off of the angle that Jarvis Landry blocks the defender. In this case, instant engage gets the block shed early. Problem has to cut it up where Safa has more defenders waiting. So that's another key to this defense. You want that instant engage whenever that outside defender doesn't come in for the block shed potential. Now once again, third time, Problem gonna try and go back to the single back A slot HB stretch to the strong side. And when you're looking at this defensive front, if you're Problem, hypothetically, this should be open, right? You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 offensive blockers compared to Safa's, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 defensive players right here. Fifth one being the strong side defensive end. And so it looks like, if your problem, that this is open. So problem once again goes to it. This is one play later, second and 11. He had just lost a yard running the same exact play. And you're going to see once again, Safa ends up stonewalling it. This time, problem doesn't go with the inside motion. And you see what that does. The outside cornerback who Safa manned up on Jarvis Landry gets the inside beat. Landry on the outside, you can see him right here, left blocking nobody. He comes straight in. Problem can literally do nothing. You see, it is the cover six once again, because you see the right side defensive back safety dropping into that deep half zone, backpedaling. But that's, it's all about the strong side. This safety coming up in run support because he's in that deep quarter zone, and then the outside defender coming in through the gap because he was manned up to the outside wide receiver. In this case, Fournette gets the ball. As soon as he gets the ball, he's just pancaked by Bo Jackson right there, and problem literally had nowhere to go. Safa held problem to what we could see on stream, 6 carries for 15 yards, which is abysmal for somebody like problem, who is usually so dominant on the ground. So really, the blueprint to stopping those HB stretches: cover six, man up the outside wide receiver with the outside quarter zone. You have the best of both worlds. You get the run support, the double run support on the quarter zone side between the safety and the outside cornerback. You get the run support on the backside with the Tampa 2 cloud flat, and that seems to be the best way to slow down these single back HB stretch based offenses. So that's going to be it for this video, guys. I hope this was able to help you guys out. As always, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take it easy.